Our nomination for the best strategic company is Netflix. Back in 2014, all the way to early 2016, major newspaper publishers and industry stated that Netflix growth would slow down and it had reached its peak. But in early 2017, Netflix proved everyone wrong and gained 7 million global subscribers within the first quarter. So, how did Netflix do it? Netflix CEO Reed Hastings says it's all a cumulative effect. Very few people will join because of one title, but there's a tipping point. When Netflix continually releases single titles that generate a lot of excitement, all the talk triggers people to finally sign up. In the past, we have seen them create their original very successful series, such as House of Cards, 13 Reasons Why, Narcos, Stranger Things, Orange is the New Black, and the list goes on. Chief Content Officer Ted Serenados elaborated on what Hastings said and drove the idea that enthusiasm for the service goes up when the Netflix Originals lineup grows. Netflix uses Originals as their main way to boost up company revenue. In 2017, they were pledging to use $7 billion towards creating and expanding current Netflix Originals.
Some in the U.S. have doubted whether Netflix can maintain its market dominance.
You are the co-founder and CEO of Netflix.
Yeah.
Your company has over 65 million members, and during peak hours from 9 to midnight in the United States, you account for 37% of all North American internet traffic.
But Netflix hasn't grown complacent. It is available in 43% of all American households, which means the U.S. market has less opportunity for growth. For this reason, Netflix has aggressively pivoted to stake claim as the first global television network. Netflix's domestic subscriber growth has always matched Wall Street's expectations, but recently, the company has grown unexpectedly large globally, and Asia is the next big target. Netflix does this by distributing shows produced specifically for non-US markets, but will still be available for American subscribers, such as Marseille, a French political drama, or Habana, a Japanese drama about the country's competitive comedy scene. As the number of subscribers from other countries grow, so too has Netflix's library of original content.
With the worldwide launch, Netflix has launched a platform upon which it can build and differentiate the service to fit specifics of every region in the future. Netflix is starting to localize in Poland and Turkey this year. Subscribers in these countries can expect an addition of local languages to the user interface, subtitles, and dubbing of content. This will help drive new subscribers' number dramatically. But Netflix doesn't try to offer content geared to a single audience with a specific interest, nor does it aim for a mass audience. So how does Netflix with 93 million subscribers pull it off? Netflix has adopted a combining niche strategy, which means it develops programs for a handful of different audience interests. These include complicated serial dramas like House of Cards, action series like Daredevil, horror series like Hemlock Grove, and exclusive films starring popular actors such as Adam Sandler and Bella Thorne.
They have a competitive advantage since they produce originals and exclusive content a lot faster. With a majority of their cast being new actors and actresses, Netflix saves money while producing more often than other competitors. They also drop new features like watching offline and showing users movies and shows that match their tastes based on previous browsing. Hulu falls behind when it comes to produced originals and originals quality, while Crave TV and Amazon Video are even further in the dust when it comes to original content. Competitors just can't create content at the same pace and within such a calculated budget as Netflix, which makes it a very sustainable competitive advantage. Netflix uses growth and diversification strategies and can be closest matched to a multi-domestic strategy, since they customize products based off of area languages and local markets as much as possible. They have a polycentric view rather than an ethnocentric view that looks at the world as one large market. When talking about adaptive strategies, Netflix incorporates a reactor and a prospector strategy, meaning they keep current shows running and releasing, while also actively seek out intelligent opportunities to create new originals and features. No television distributor has ever been able to reach a truly global audience. Netflix's experiment as a global subscriber-funded television portal may be the next chapter of television history. Due to Netflix's strong growth and diversification strategies, focused adaptive strategies, and a clear competitive advantage in satisfying consumers. This is why we nominate them for the best strategic company.